copyright to decide the number of children and spacing on the number of children. And we talk and talk about decent work. What we're just trying to mean is that wherever you are working, the place should be conducive enough. There should be safety. Your health should be a concern. Maybe the employee should always take care of your health. In Ghana here, our normal working hour is 8 hours. So if you're working more than 8 hours and you're not being paid on time, then you're working at the center. That's what we claim at the center. Now, if you work with a female person and that female partner is paid more than you are being paid, all you guys are working the same hours. It's not a decent job. If you're working in an institution where you're not provided meat,
the law supports that.
Yes, it's not a decent job. That's what we claim as decent. It's not a decent job to us. Now, if you're working in a place where your employee don't care about your health, no maternity leave, your meat is not being catered, but you don't care more than at this time. Now, let's go to our last thematic area, unpaid health. This is a great issue in that area. Unpaid health simply means the domestic house chores that women do about the cooking, the sleeping, the washing of dishes, but people don't see it as well. So we term it unpaid problem. Women do all this work and they are not being paid for it. And their husband is deciding to do that as well. So they have to help to organize parents, the individual, to educate them. Women are being paid for it. Guys go to maybe they travel international and do this thing, they are chefs. But they're being paid for. When they come to Ghana and they are told to do the same thing, the claim is that with the work of women, which we are saying that they should know that it is a work. They should when it comes to young women, we have 3 hours. We have the work should be recognized as a work. It should be redistributed.
Redistribution.
Yes, redistribution of the work. So that everyone have a share of it.
What's the first one?
The first
one.
Recognized. Yes, that is a work. Don't take care work is a work. And the second hour is redistribution. If you take part, this thing don't want to take part, I have to take part. We are going to do it. And the last one is reduction. When this is done, the burden of women will be reduced. These are the three other we are hammering on. The people should make sure all these people work. So the burden of women also wants to be reduced.
Great. How many women you are serving now?
How many women? We are serving about 1,000 women. We are working with those in school and those who are out of school.
Out school.
Yes.
The out school are they are working in domestic work.
Those out of school.
Yeah.
Yes.
Like in houses.
We also cleaning
something like that.
Yes. We also done livelihood training.
Okay.
Yeah, that's a bit making. Those that they can learn petty trading, bits making, how to do the necklace and stuff, and liquid soap.
Okay.
Yes. We also have people that women that we have enrolled in this kind of tiling. I don't know how.
Tiling.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, for tiling, and people are also doing it, and we have coconuts. We send this women there to learn to have they can train and have participated in the way that they train.
You mean handicraft?
Yes, something like that.
So, how can we help you? And it's very interesting, especially when you talk about these 3 hours. How can we help you? What do you think? What type of help? Since we are not charity organization.
How can we help us?
Yes.
Okay. We have been doing this for a while.
Huh?
We have been doing this for a while. So if you come in to support us, maybe.
How many of you, by the way? Okay, and you as ladies taking care of this, how many of you?
How many of us? We have executives of 11. Yeah, we are the main executives. Monitoring all these towers, you really, as I speak of earlier on.
Those who train them to be handicraft or tiles or do they become more independent? Do you try? How many years have we been doing this?
That's what the problem is, and we have the chance to train them on the skills, but what the problem is, they don't have the means of further activity after the training. They go back to their house. The money that they'll get to start that small capital becomes a problem, and we are not with bank institutions just to provide them with the skills. So if we get maybe an institution will provide us with capital that we give to them, maybe they can pay bit by bit, monitoring them how they are going through the payment. So that will equip them with mind to start their business, or their skills that we have equipped them with.
First, I want from you two issues. You go and study it first. How many of them they have skills that we can start with them? Don't answer me now. Second thing, what type of machines you need to make a product that is means it's going to be sold, whether internally or externally, and it will help them to live a dignified life and so on. I need from you these two, and then the statistics, how many they are, what's their condition, okay, what's their distribution, and so on. Okay. Yeah. Now you are getting funds from Action Aid, right?
Action Aid and about to finish. Right. We are getting funds from Action Aid Ghana.
Same as the guys, ladies there.
The other said, the other place. It is the same thing. We all, they manage the two of us.
Right.
Just that we are in greater kind, we are not in return, but it's the same.
Right. Yes. Here, your problem is different than there. Your problems here is different than there.
Yeah, yeah.
Here you have, for example, domestic worker ladies working in houses. Right?
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
What is the kind of organization again?
A bank for development.
I want to see from you, and you are focusing on productivity, to enhance the productivity of the organization. Small investment, but it will help you to enhance and to be more independent. You know?
Yes.
That's it. So, I need to know more, Yanni, if you have anything in photos, in videos, and numbers.
Okay, since we have video.
No, only a meeting, I know. We are tired and you are tired, and we need to study, you know, anyway, because we have many project promises. We want to categorize them, which one are more important.
Okay.
But yeah, these are the things that are worthwhile. Anything else that I...
Anything else that you want to...
Okay, so the SRH, what does it mean again?
Sexual reproductive health and wellness.
The years that you started, what has been some of your successes?
Okay, when it comes to teenage pregnancy, it's also part of the SRHM, the number of people who were friends into the number of people who has cases of teenage pregnancy has reduced.
Reduction is?
Yes, and we've created a friendly corner at Amasama.
You have numbers.
Numbers. When numbers, we don't have.
She will do that. She will do that.
So
she knows now.
We send the boss as doing as an assignment to all we work in that. And we have, as I said, a friendly health corner that the girls can fully work. You see, in Ghana, if you're a young lady and you're pregnant, the way you are treated is not fair. So we have been able to have a youth friendly corner. That anyone can walk there, you treated fairly as.
So you have a facility?
Yeah, yes. Adamas at our clinic in Amasama.
So, maybe in case of any workshop, can we organize this?
We have a center. We have a center. You're not unfortunate you didn't come to our center. We have a center, we have a conference room, an ICT lab.
Same as it is in Kamali.
So, we have a big center that will.
Let us be introduced for this.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's my colleague. Yeah, so I'm Margaret. She's my colleague as well. From the Young Development Movement.
You are same? Accra. Same or different?
No. Same. From Accra.
I know, but you are same. Yani, same organization.
Yes.
Somebody else.
You know what you said so far.
You said about domestic women workers, about women rights, about sexual protection,
right, so
about fair, decent payment.
She has been able to mention some of the basic things, but then let me just walk you through our thematic areas. Then those things she said will come under them. So we work around three thematic areas, and formerly it was on decent work, on paid care work, and then sexual and reproductive health. So now, because of the Sustainable Development Goals, we try to link what we do with the Sustainable Development Goals. So doing sexual and reproductive health is now bodily integrity. Working on decent work is economic security. And then with the decent unpaid care work is now burden of care work. So this is where we work. And we also do general basic skills, hand skills. So we train young women on how to get some soft skills. That's if you don't even have a decent work to do, you can be in the house and then do to raise some capital or some funds to cater for yourself. Apart from that, also we partner with some organization to come out with some activities basically around the thematic areas. So if you have the same interests, we come together, we sit down, and then we talk about what we can do better. Then we come out with an activity. She has said more.
So,
but
how best can we collaborate with you?
How best? Sure, so we are just there. We are there. Apart from we partnering with other organizations, ActionAid is a bigger umbrella with the Young Urban Women. So most of our activities, they support us with some funds, or not funds alone, resources, let me put it in that way. So resources. So partnering with us wouldn't be a problem. I think it's supposed to be on what you are going to do.
So since you're maybe training women, soap making, handicraft, and then other things, if you wanted to come train or upload some of these things, would you be willing to?
Sure. So if that we need to set and schedule times, that will favor us, because we also have our time schedule.
I think this is a problem, but let me, I think this later I can talk to them, I think I'm sure they will come. But these products, I want to, how many years you've been doing this training?
The training. So we've been in existence for 5 years now.
So is there any products that came from this that you managed to sell it, you package it properly? She spoke about the tiling, about the soaps, about the handicraft.
Yeah.
What happened to your brother? Where did they go?
So I am a beneficiary.
Okay.
Of the soap making and then the beads making. We have other young women. We have one woman who is now a tailor. That's her job for living. That's her job.
And she's getting enough?
Exactly. So she
is. That's a good model. We can start with that. We want to measure how much it affected her livelihood, as you mentioned about livelihood. Okay. And if it is this, then we can help you to generalize the model.
Okay.
That's a good one. Instead of only solving problem, that's also capital, and we'll have two ways. When solving a problem, by what we do, we improve productivity. Okay, as I explained to you. Whether in the beginning, by investing raw material or machines, or in the end of the process, which means supply chain, which means marketing, labeling, packaging, distribution, that's what it is. That's our. And diversifying the products means, is the soap, this is needed in the market? Which market is needed? Is it needed in the local market? Maybe the return is very low.
Yeah.
How can we sell it if it's organic soap? How can we sell it to?
Outside.
Okay. Market that appreciate that such a soap. So that's good that anyway we met you, because we were waiting. I know you are...
No, it's okay.
But most important that we met. I believe that we can work with you, inshallah. And we've seen your sisters also there. So we are very excited. to work with all of you.
Thank you.
And I feel all of each one of you is inspiring. This team, the urban, I have something feeling they will do something.
Yeah.
Now, frankly, that's my internal feeling.
Thank you.
I met many. I know how many women. 30 organizations maybe you met?
Yes.
Approximately. In Jodz. And we did a training there. I wish we have done a training in Accra also. We did a training for all the NGOs that we met in Somalia. What we can do for you also, guys, to clip you also in our program. Same what we should have told these ladies, huh?
So which organization?
We have two programs coming up, inshallah. One program is about a workshop about problem solving.
Problem solving.
So for a community.
Okay.
Second program is long program, 6 months with certificate. Both of them certificate. That one is a workshop. That one is a program. That one to prepare you for us to solve a problem in different countries, not even here. During the workshop, it is two-way communication. I won't be here, but I will send PowerPoint recorded. And then we'll have a Skype meeting, wherever these people, whoever that is asking you for a venue.
Okay.
Yes. So that's right. Anything else? Anything else from your side?
Do you have any questions?
Yeah.
Do you have any questions?
So I think my
I'll give you my card also so that you guys.
I don't really have a problem, but my problem would have to be with communication. Communication is very, very, very important to us because we have other particular things we do. We have a lineup activity in a year we do. So it is better we communicate early before any program comes up so that we'll be able to know how to schedule our plans very well. So we can fix in any program that comes
I think they will communicate with you
exactly.
For sure early. Because we want you in the program.
So that is my concern.
I think we have to move because I'm very tired. But these are the things that are required. Anything else that I...
Anything else that you want to...
Okay, so the SRH, what does it mean again?
Sexual reproductive health and wellness.
So, in the years that you started, what has been some of your successes?
Okay, when it comes to teenage pregnancy, it's also part of the SRH, I mean, to know SRH. The number of people who were friends into it.
Hello.
The number of people.
Hello.
Who has cases of teenage pregnancy has reduced.
Reduction
is. Yes, and we've created a friendly corner at.
We have friendly corner at our master.
It's not friends, so we have been able to have a youth friendly corner that anyone can walk there and be treated fairly as.
So you have a facility in Accra?
Yes. Adamas at our clinic in Amasama. Yes.
So maybe in case of any workshop, can we organize this?
We have a center. We have a center. You know, unfortunately, you didn't come to our center. We have a center, we have a conference room. An ICT lab. So we have a big center that will.
Let us be introduced for this.
There's my colleague.
Yeah, so I'm Margaret. She's my colleague as well from the Young Urban Women's Movement.
You are same? Accra. Same or different?
No. Same. From Accra.
I know, but you are same. Same organization.
Yes. What she said so far.
She said about domestic women workers, about women rights, about sexual protection, about fair, decent payment.
Okay. So I think she has been able to mention some of the basic things. But then let me just us walk you through our thematic areas, then those things she said will come under them. So we work around three thematic areas. And formerly it was on decent work, on paid care work, and then sexual and reproductive health. So now, because of the sustainable development goals, we try to link what we do with the sustainable development goals. So doing sexual and reproductive health is now bodily integrity. Working on decent work is economic security. And then with the decent unpaid care work is now burden of care work. So this is where we work. And we also do general basic skills, hand skills. So we train young women on how to get some soft skills. That's if you don't even have it.
She will do that.
So
she knows now.
We send the boss as dinners and assignments. We all work in that. And we have, you know, as I said, a friendly health corner that the girls can fully work. You see, in Ghana here, if you're a young lady and you're pregnant, the way you are treated, it's not fair. So we have been able to have a youth friendly corner that anyone can work there and be treated fairly. As
so you have a facility.
Yes, at our clinic in
Amasama.
Yes.
So, maybe in case of any workshop, can we organize this?
We have a center. Very unfortunately, you didn't come to our center. We have a conference room, an ICT lab.
So, we have a big center that will. Let us be introduced for this.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
That's my colleague. Yeah, so I'm Margaret. My colleague as well from the Young Urban Women's Movement.
You are same? Accra. Same or different?
No. Same. From Accra.
I know, but you are same. Same organization.